Hi everyone, ये revision video, this is the revision video for English medium students, chapter number 4. In the last video we have discussed some numericals of exercise. In this video we will see Biot-Savart law, okay. And in the next video we will see application of Biot-Savart law. So with Biot-Savart law we can find out the magnetic field, okay. With the help of this is the first law. That has achieved to find out the magnetic field. Okay, so how Biot-Savart law was invented? Suppose this is one wire. This is a wire of uneven shape. From this wire, some current I is flowing. Okay, from this wire some current I is flowing, then this wire is generating magnetic field around the wire. Okay, if the current is flowing from this wire, then this wire will behave as a magnet and around this wire magnetic field will generate. So suppose this point B, which is at distance r from the some small element current. From this full wire current I is flowing, but suppose we are considering only one small element of current that has length dl, so that small element of current is called idl. Okay, and if we want to find out the magnetic field at point P due to this small element, we will find out the magnetic field at point P. So Biot-Savart law suggested that if from the wire current I is flowing and at point P, if we want to find out magnetic field, then this magnetic field dB is equal to mu 0 idl cross r, mu 0 idl cross r upon r cube. Okay, now this is the Biot-Savart law. Okay, Biot-Savart law suggested that if current is flowing from the wire, then around the wire at some distance r, this is the distance r, vector r, then at distance r at point P, magnetic field is given by this formula mu 0 idl cross r upon r cube. Okay, mu 0 idl cross r upon r cube. This is the Biot-Savart law. 4 pi, mu 0 upon 4 pi. Mu 0 upon 4 pi idl cross r upon r cube. ये law को हम ऐसे भी लिख सकते हैं, dB is equal to mu 0 upon 4 pi idl cross r cap upon r square. ओके, r upon r को हमने r cap लिख दिया, r cap is equal to vector r upon mod of r. तो ये combination को हमने r cap लिख दिया. तो ये लॉ को हम ऐसे भी लिख सकते हैं, mu 0 upon 4 pi idl cross r cap upon r square, तो ये तो वही है inverse square rule. ओके, ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स फाइंड किया वो भी इनवर्स स्क्वायर रूट से फाइंड किया, इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स फाइंड किया वो भी इनवर्स स्क्वायर रूट से फाइंड किया, तो ये भी इनवर्स स्क्वायर रूल है बायोट-सावर्ट का. ओके, तो ये भी नेचर का लॉ है, इसका प्रूफ जो है वो हमें नहीं पढ़ना है, इसका डायरेक्ट फॉर्मूला याद रखना है बायोट-सावर्ट का. तो बायोट-सावर्ट में सब टर्म्स क्या है वो खास इंपॉर्टेंट आपको याद रखनी चाहिए. सपोज अगर आपको पूछा 2 मार्क्स में कि एक्सप्लेन टू बायोट-सावर्ट लॉ, ओके, देन यू विल एक्सप्लेन Biot-Savart law by figure, write down its formula, and you will also write all the terms in this formula. Suppose first is mu zero. What is mu zero? That is the permeability of vacuum or air. Okay, mu zero is the permeability of the vacuum or air. फ्री स्पेस उसकी वैल्यू आएगी 4 pi into 10 raise to -7, उसकी वैल्यू आएगी 4 pi into 10 raise to -7 यूनिट. यूनिट आप यहां से निकाल सकते हो, नेगेटिव फील्ड का यूनिट होगा टेस्ला, ओके मैग्नेटिक फील्ड का टेस्ला एम्पियर मीटर 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 क्यूब, यहां से हार्ड लगता है तो यहां से निकालो टेस्ला, इसका यूनिट होगा टेस्ला एम्पियर मीटर मीटर स्क्वायर, तो एक ही मीटर रहेगा सो टेस्ला मीटर पर एम्पियर, ओके सो इसका यूनिट आएगा टेस्ला मीटर पर एम्पियर, सो दिस इज द यूनिट। Here mu first mu zero is the permeability. Then I is current flowing from the wire. I is current flowing from the wire in ampere. The ampere is small element. DL is small element that we have considered due to which we are finding the magnetic field at point P. So DL is the only small element R. R is displacement vector of point P. R is displacement vector of point P with respect to dl. Okay, R is displacement vector of point P with respect to dl, and at point P we will find out magnetic field. So these are all the terms that has covered in Biot-Savart law. Okay, and with the help of Biot-Savart law we can find out magnetic field. Now we will see some important points about Biot-Savart law. First we will find out the direction of the magnetic field. See, we will find out the direction of the magnetic field at point P. That is achieved by dl cross r, idl cross r. So in which direction? Then there is r. In y direction, so suppose j cap. In which direction there is r? In x direction, so suppose it is I cap. So it will be minus k cap. J cross I, that is minus k. Okay, so at point P magnetic field is in negative z axis direction. At point P it will be negative z axis direction. Or another method is set your thumb in the direction of current, then our finger, then direction of our 12 fingers will give the direction of magnetic field. So if thumb is upward, then our fingers are inward at point P. So at point P magnetic field is inward, and inward is suggested by cross. Inward is shown by cross. Okay, so this is how we can find out the direction. Now switch some important points about Biot-Savart law, that is the, and also we can say that there is the comparison between electric field and magnetic field. Okay, there is the comparison between electric field and magnetic field, or Coulomb's law and Biot-Savart law. First is both are long range forces, up to some distance both force will take place. Okay, so this is the first, and both are inverse square rule, and both are up to some higher range, up to some long distance rule. Second point, that is important. Electric field is generated by a base charge. Suppose here we have base charge Q, then this charge will generate electric field around it. But moving charge, here there is a current I, so current I is actually flow of charge. So in current I there is flow of charge, movement of charge. So raised charge is generating electric field, whereas moving charge is generating magnetic field. Okay, raised charge is generating electric field, whereas moving charge is generating magnetic field. Now third point, in electric field, in formula of the electric field, suppose what is the formula of the electric field? That is K Q by R square, 1 upon 4 by epsilon 0 Q by R square. So in formula of electric field there is no vector product. Okay, so we are not using any vector relation, any vector product to find out the electric field. Though electric field is vector quantity, but here to find out magnetic field, we are using the vector relations. Okay, so magnetic field or Biot-Savart law is depending on vector rules. Biot-Savart law is depending on vector rules. Okay. So this is the third point. Final point, this formula, we can write this formula also by this way. dB is equals to mu 0 upon 4 pi idl r sin theta, idl sin theta upon r square. We can also write this formula by this way. That means this magnetic field is depending on theta. This magnetic field is depending on theta, whereas electric field is not depending on any theta, any angle. Okay, again, magnetic field is depending on theta angle, whereas electric field is not depending on any angle theta. Final point, next point is, in which direction there is electric field? Suppose this Q. At point A, we have to find out electric field. Then, at point A, electric field will be in this direction. So, we can say that electric field is in the plane of charge. See, this is the plane. Or in this plane only, there will be electric field. So, electric field is in the direction of the line joining the charge at the point. Or else, electric field is in the plane of the charge. Whereas, here magnetic field is, suppose charge is flowing in this direction, so in this plane, and magnetic field is in what? Negative z-axis direction, so it is in another plane. Okay, so simply here electric field is in the direction of line joining charge and the point, whereas magnetic field is perpendicular to the movement of charge. Here in this direction there is movement of charge. So magnetic field is perpendicular to the movement of charge. So this is the equivalence and difference between Coulomb's law and Barrett-Savart law. Okay, this is the equivalence between Coulomb's law and Barrett-Savart law. That is important for 2 marks question. Again, we are revising. First point is, both are long distance ray forces and both are inverse curvature. Okay, second is, electric field is not depending on vector product, whereas magnetic field is depending on vector product. Electric field is not depending on any angle theta, magnetic field is depending on angle theta. And finally, electric field is in the direction of the line joining between charge and the point, whereas magnetic field is perpendicular to the movement of charge. So this is the difference. Okay. Now we will do one example based on Barrett-Savart law. See, we have given one illustration. In illustration we have given that there is small element of current, from it current is flowing in positive x-axis direction. So current is flowing in this direction, I. Okay, this is point B, and we are asked to find out the magnetic field at point B. This is delta x is 1 cm. Find out the magnetic field at point P. Current flowing from this element is 10 ampere. And this R, the distance between origin to P, that R is given 0.5 meter. Okay, this is the illustration number 5. So in illustration 5, we have given that there is one small element of current which is placed on origin point, which is of length 1 cm, from which current is flowing in x direction, that is 10 ampere. Find out the magnetic field at point B, which is at 0.5 meter from the origin. Now, according to Barrett-Savart law, we can say that magnetic field at point B is equal to mu 0 upon 4 pi Idl cross R upon R cube. Okay, now in this case, what is the direction between Idl and R? See, I current is in x direction, whereas R in y direction. So angle is 90 degree. So we can say that BP is equal to, place the value of mu 0, that is 4.2 × 10⁻¹. You already know that value of mu 0 for the permeability of air is 4.2 × 10⁻¹ upon 4 pi into I dl. R 1 R will be cancelled, divided by R square, and sin 90. Okay, so value of sin 90 is 1. I dl cross R, that means I dl R sin 90, but 1 R is getting cancelled. Now, finally, place all the values सो 10 रेस टू माइनस 7 7 के ऑन 9 रेस टू माइनस 7 विल बी देयर करंट आई इज 10 एम्पीयर ओके इनटू डीएल डीएल इज एलिमेंट इट इज 1 सेंटीमीटर सो 1 इनटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 2 इनटू sin 90 sin 1 डिवाइड बाय r स्क्वायर r इज 0.5 सो 0.5 स्क्वायर सो बाय कैलकुलेशन यू कैन फाइंड आउट द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ओके इट इज आउट Then direction. You can find also find out direction. How you can find out direction? That is, set your thumb in the direction of current, then the direction of curl fingers. That is outside. So at point P, magnetic field will be outside. Okay, in positive z axis or outward perpendicular to the plane. This is how we can find out the direction of magnetic field. It is illustration number 5. So this is the illustration number 5. Okay. When you will do it, then you will get the answer. That is 4 into 10 raised to minus 8 tesla. That you can find out. Answer you can manage. Okay. So this is the illustration number 5. I hope.